Ọnụnụlọ mara ihe a zụrụ n'ahịa is possible. Imadi ọkpara izizi. Welcome back, family and friends, to the Woke Nation. And I'm still talking about who are you praying to when you pray. So before the interruption, I was talking about the ancestors after Mary. Like those in African spirituality, those that believe they are not Christians, they are not Muslims, they are not Jews, but they are Africans, and they believe in spirituality. In African spirituality, they also believe in God. They believe there is higher being, supreme being. My tribe call their own Chukwu Okike Abiyama, or Chineke, or Chukwu. Before Christianity came to Igbo land, Igbo people believe in Chukwu. That's why they were giving their children Chukura, Chukuma, Chukwude, Chukwuneke or Chukwunenye. It's not Christian names, but you know, most Igbos who are Christians, bearing like Chinedu, Chinenye, they thought it's a Christian name. No, it's not. Chukuma or Chukura, those things are Igbo names, and people that believe in Igbo cosmology, where they believe, you know, spirituality and all that. I don't believe them. I need to know them. You see that? I don't believe in Igbo's African spirituality. I need to know it. But I know it's a belief system. It has nothing to do with natural facts. Like, they try to mix it with nature. Nature is nature. That you said, okay, my belief now, I'm basing it on nature, does not make it natural thing. So, and does not make nature a spiritual thing. You know, nature is nature, spiritual thing is spiritual thing. And if you're talking about spiritual thing, count me out. I'm not going with you on that route, because I know it will lead me nowhere. It cannot put food on my table. It will only make me think, I believe I can fly, but I cannot fly. All right. So, who are you talking to when you pray? You say you're praying to your ancestors. Have you seen this, your ancestor you're talking about? Or you just believe our ancestors are somewhere, you know, they're hanging somewhere, watching us, they can do this. No, your ancestors are dead, and they cannot do anything. They are already reincarnated, and you are one of them. So praying to your ancestors is just like the same thing they say Jesus did in the Bible. They say Jesus is God, praying to God. So Jesus, the same thing you said, oh, I don't believe in Christianity, I don't believe in Islam. It's the same thing you are doing in African spirituality. The truth is this, historical fact. African spirituality is the mother of Islam, Christianity, and Judaism. Every religion in this world finds their root in African spirituality. And African spirituality is based on mythology. So that doesn't mean, okay, because is African spirituality. That means it's real. Those imitations are fake. No, it's the same spirit. The foundation is there. Spirituality is belief system. It's not the truth. And that's why in it, nobody forces you to believe what they believe. They say you can believe. So people begin to develop all kinds of belief. But religion is organized where they force you. If you don't believe in Jesus, you will be born in hell. If you don't believe in Islam, you will be killed. You are infidel. All that nonsense. So religion comes with force, forcing people to believe. But in spirituality, you don't force people. And everybody, you know, Onyenachi, any way you see is working for you, do it. And you don't, that's why when Africans enslaved Europeans, they didn't force them to be converted. But when the Europeans and Arabs enslaved Africans, they forced them to be converted to their religion. In spirituality, you don't force anyone to be a convert or to follow you. No. But in religion, you must force people. So that's only different between spirituality and religion. But both of them, I trust all of them. I don't need them. None of them can provide for me. None of them. If any of them works, I won't be in America today. Okay? But the main reason why I'm in America is what I'm doing now, to wake you up. Haven't you noticed that most Africans that loved it, that used to be after that they care about the truth, about facts, anytime they leave the shores of Africa, they change. Look at somebody like Fela. Immediately Fela traveled to America, he changed. When he read the book of Malcolm S, he changed. Because there are some of our brethren in America who had the means, what it takes to go and dig out the truth. They went to Egypt. They went to different parts of Africa. They're the one that brought the truth to the light. So they begin to debunk all the lies that Hollywood, religion, and the European governments and the Arabic government gave to us. Before they taught us that Egyptians were white, but we found out, no, they are black. Blacker than me. they are Africans. So who are you talking to when you pray? You say you pray to your ancestors, and as I was saying, I knew my ancestors, like my great my grandfather from my mother's side, Ekwemba, and my grandmother from my mother's side, Aburak. Then from my on my father's side, I didn't see my grandfather. But I saw my grandmother, Meshishi Shedrack, and the name Shedrack. My name is Shedrack, right? Shedrack incarnated me. I'm the incarnation of Shedrack. So when you're talking about the father to my earthly father or to my real father, I am the father to my father. So in our tribe, my father should be calling me my father or his father, Nnam, which our people do. It doesn't mean you are greater, though. It means, oh, he recognized you. And you see how he'll be treating you like his father. But you know, Christianity came and destroyed all that. We don't know who is who anymore. Oh, at my job 2 days ago, this African-American lady came to me. She said, oh, I found my root. I'm a Kenyan. I came from Kenya. I said, okay. She said, the only thing remaining now is to find my tribe, to know my tribe. Guess what was my reply? I said, the only person that will do that is the voodoo priest in Kenya. She said she wants to go to Kenya. I said, yeah, when you get there, don't worry. The voodoo priest there will help you to locate your tribe. And it's true. But the thing is, those things are natural things, as I was saying before the interruption. Those things you call spirituality, African spirituality, they are natural things that people, it is people doing it. There's no any spiritual being that spirit being that appear doing anything. You say they saw something. Yeah, it is with their mind. We have that ability. You're supposed to, all of them are natural, whether visible or invisible. They are natural things. Once you begin to spiritualize them, that's how you begin to fall. And that's how we fail as a people. We begin to spiritualize things we have natural ability to know and to do. Then white people came and took advantage of it and forced us to embrace their religion. Yeah, and have you seen the ancestors you're talking to? Do you see them? If you cannot see them, stop talking to them. When you don't see them, you are talking to them, you are stupid. Yes, you. It doesn't matter who you are, whether you are native doctor, whether you are king, whatever your rank in your culture, in your tradition. You haven't seen your ancestors, you don't see them, and you are praying to them, and you know they are dead, and yet you're praying. And that's another way Africans are messed up. You hear that preacher, Igila, or what they call him, he was defending TB Joshua against other ministers of God in the different camp, but in Christianity, talking against TB Joshua. He said, in Yoruba land, where he came from, there are two things that happens that will make you reconcile with somebody. And those two things, to me, they are stupid things that will make you reconcile with somebody. He said, first is when somebody put to bed. So, if somebody has been against me, and I know this person was actually out to destroy my life, then because she put to bed, or because the wife put to bed, I have to come and reconcile? That's stupidity. No, don't do that. And that's what has been killing people, even in Yoruba land. If you know the history or what is happening in Yoruba land, you understand. It's only Igbo people that seem to their own always out there. If you know, hear some people talking nonsense, Igbos hate themselves. Go ask Yoruba people how they live in their villages. Go. Some of them cannot even travel to their village unless they fortify themselves with a powerful Babalawo charm. They go to church. Celestial. Why do you see most Yoruba people in Celestial Church? Government church, where they do rituals and all that for fortification. That's what they do. Then he said the second one is when somebody's dead. So, you respect the dead. No, I respect the living, not the dead. If we weren't talking when you were alive, you die. I'm not coming. I don't want to talk with you. You are dead. Get out. I celebrate. If you say you are my enemy when you are alive, then you die. You want me to celebrate? You must be stupid. I'm not stupid. I will celebrate you die. Yeah, you die. Sigh of relief is gone. Let me continue. Because I will die too. But these are the things they use to keep people in bondage. Oh, you have issue with somebody, reconcile with that person when somebody put to bed or when somebody died. So if you rejoice when somebody was born, why can't you rejoice when somebody's dead? Huh? And the quote Bible, rejoice with them that is dead. Weep with them or cry with them that cry. That's nonsense. Who are you praying to? Who are you talking to in prayer? You haven't seen that person. You cannot see that person right now. And you say you are praying. You come out, you are pouring libation, my ancestors. Those things are nonsense. Your ancestors want you to live like them, better than them. Not pouring all this thing, praying all that. That's nonsense. Your ancestors are not taking. That's nonsense. It's make believe. It doesn't work. You are the one that making it work. It's not, it doesn't work. You say, you believe there is charm. No, I don't believe, I know. And it's a natural thing. There are things you can put together, something happen. That's when you bring negative wire and the positive wire and put them together, a spark doesn't come out. You say, so you believe in spark. No, I don't believe in spark. I know it's happened. I know. That's one of the reasons why you run away from your village. That's one of the reasons why your parents become Christians or going to church. They are afraid of native daughters. They are afraid of those charms. Oh, it happened. It happened. He said, no, it doesn't happen. Okay, you said no, right? Okay. Then you don't know. You see the train rail, right? You stand there. I say, there's no train coming. No, no train. But the rail was there, right? Don't worry. Keep standing there. The train will pass there one day. And you keep stand there. Don't move. It will cross you. If you cannot see them, it is because they are imaginary beings. Person or people you believe have heard. You say they speak. You say they speak. If that person or that people speaks, if you cannot see them, it's because they are imaginary beings. They are not real. You are hearing the voices in your head. If you cannot see them, it is because they are imaginary beings. They are not real beings. Stop being stupid by faith in imaginary being, whether in African spirituality or foreign religion. In every belief system, you are stupid being there. You keep doing stupid things. Wake up. Talking to the wind is mental problem. You're just speaking to the wind. I'm calling on me. I'm doing this will happen here. As we go to this place, go before us. Send this to us. Don't let this thing happen to us. Don't let things keep happening to you. As I said in the part one, that being, that God you are praying to, is he deaf and blind? If that God can see and can speak, you don't need to pray. You keep asking, give us this day our daily bread. You are stupid. I like the way Darosa put it when he was alive. He said, give us this day our daily bread. So the prayer you pray one day should carry you the rest of the year. Like January 1, you who believe in 12 months of the year. If on January 1 you made a prayer, the prayer you made on that January 1 should be able to carry you to December 31st of that year. That is what is called living by faith. But you know you are not living by faith. You pray every day because your God does not exist. If your God exists, just pray that one prayer in January. Then wait until the next January 1st for you to pray another one. At least that one will show some sense. Okay, yeah, it's prayer of faith. Give us this day our daily bread. Can you pray and stop praying? Then God will keep providing your daily bread. No, because God does not exist. You are just making noise. You are just speaking into the wind in prayer. You are a mad person. And after prayer, you will call me a mad person. I don't pray. I don't fast. No, I don't. I don't worship any God. I don't. And you call me a mad person. But you are the one praying. You are the one fasting. You are the one worshiping. Praying to God you have not seen or can see. Praying to imaginary beings you cannot see or can see. You see that idiot came on in bus. I didn't even invite him, but he came. Say, what do you mean? I agree with you with many things you are saying, but now, you know, there is God. Okay, so then go and have discussion with that God. If there is God, don't come arguing with me. Don't come talking to me. Talk with God. Talk to your God to come and talk to me. Since he's too afraid to come to me directly, go and talk to him to come. I will not kill him. Unless he refuses to answer my question, then I kill him. Tell him to come. Then he begins to talk rubbish. I say, listen, get out of my inbox. He said, I'm a confused creature. Me, creature? I am confused. You that believe in invisible God is saying to somebody that does not believe that person is confused. And this God you cannot show. This God you cannot discuss with this God. Huh? You say, who created the world, everything? I say, dragon created it. You say, no, dragon is the devil. And so, did he tell you that devil cannot create anything? Huh? Your God has children. Devil has children. Welcome, these people, please. I'm talking to you because you exist. I'm not speaking to the wind. You are, see my people on my profile. It's not God that opened your profile. You open it. You are a human being. You can hear me. You can see me. And that's why I'm talking to you. Hi. Prayer is a delusional activity. When you are praying, you are saying you are schizophrenic. You are suffering from that disease called schizophrenia, mental problem. Prayer is a complete waste of time. Why are you praying? Why are you wasting your time in prayer? That time you spend praying, use it to do push-up at least 10 or 20. Every time you say, they say, let us pray, do push-up. Do 10 or 20. You will see how you begin to look better. You begin to feel better. Your heart will begin to... You will not die like TB Joshua. He was sick. They say he was sick. And he went and collapsed and died. The one say he died in his chambers. They say they rush him in the hospital where they pronounce him dead. All that bullshit. But we know he died. And for me, as long as so long I'm concerned, I know what killed TB Joshua. It is Babalawo power. Babalawo power, super power, Jesus power, powerless power. Jesus prayed to heal TB Joshua. All his healing water and the anointing oil. When are they? When he found himself in real need. Hey, let us get to hospital. He died before they went to hospital. And they said, those people that rush into hospital, they are not people of faith. And even we tell you they are living by faith. If you are living by faith, you wouldn't have rushed into any hospital. People that go to hospital are not living by faith. When Richard Bonnke was alive, before our ancestors killed him, he went to hospital. He died. You see Benny Hinn, when he was sick, he went to hospital. Benny Hinn, oh. Benny Hinn. When he moved his hand, people will fall. He's still alive, oh. Yet you see our people believing them. How do you say that? Why are you talking against the God's choosing? Why are you talking against the anointed? You are stupid. I talk against your God. Who are the anointed? I am over them. I am above their God. So who are they? I am better than them all. Prayer is a display of stupidity. That's why you see how our parents force us to pray. Let us pray. I am lead us in prayer. I am doing it, baby. You know how we say? What if you have been showing it, baby? You know how your parents are forcing you to pray when you are a little child. And now you come and say, why do you say there is no God? Huh? There is God. God is everything to me. But you are Facebook. God is not Facebook to you. God is not social media to you. You are there because you pay money for it. God is not cell phone to you. But you say, God is everything to me. You are stupid saying that. You sound stupid and you are stupid. Prayer is a display of stupidity. Bandy Rogers said they have amnesia of the mind. Yeah. They don't colomenta. Okay, look at them Christians. Your prayer against me has proven that there is no God. For years now, you have been praying for me to go back to God, for me to come back to Jesus. You have been praying for bad things to happen to me to prove that I am against God. Oh, you are against our Creator. You will see one day. Which one day? One day is not a date. Be specific. Give me the date. And I will, the following day, I will show you. See, it did not work. But you say, so he's going to work. He will work. A blind person telling somebody that can see. Listen, you will see something. You know you are blind. I've seen more than whatever you are saying. Your prayers against me are useless. Your prayers against me are fruitless. They cannot do it just as they are fruitless to you. Are useless. Your prayer has not done anything for you. If prayer works, you won't pray for me. The reason why you are praying for me is because prayer does not work. Money works. Send money to me now. You say, no, you're not sending it to me. Money works. They tell you you cannot serve God and money. You can see money. You cannot serve God. You still believe that lie. No. We are serving money. Not God. When you go to work for money, our ancestors weren't serving money. They were producing their food, doing things. Yeah, they have their own money to do business. But they weren't serving it. Today, we are serving money, all of us. We are following that banking system that the Europeans brought to us. Our people actually has believed that without money, you are nothing. Without money, you are good. They think money is wealth. Money is not wealth. Having money does not mean you are wealthy. You don't know that. It's the land. They took our land and gave us money, and we are chasing money. And we borrow money from them, and they take our resources. It's resources, the land. That's what makes you worthy, not money. Money is like God. Oh, man, now I wish you understand it. Prayer cannot pay your bills. At least that is the truth you should tell yourself. You are the one working to make money to pay your bills. It's not prayer. It's not God. You are the doer. You are the one working that thing you call miracle in your life, in your business, in your family, in your marriage, in all your affairs. That miracle you are saying God did, you are the one that has been doing that. But because you have been brainwashed, indoctrinated, you believe there is God behind it. You are the God behind it. Prayer cannot pay your debt. Some of you still owing rent. You still owing some people. When you see them, you dodge. You pray. Some of them, you pray, they die. So they will stop disturbing you. But your prayer does not work. They still come for their money. Because it's their money. You have to pay back. If God exists, let me say it again. If God exists, you will need daily provision from Him. Not you doing daily prayer to Him. Daily prayer to God means God does not exist. Even when I was a Christian, I used to teach that when you pray for one thing, don't pray for it again. Because if you pray for it again, you have canceled the one you prayed before. So if God maybe would have used 20 minutes to answer your previous prayer, you have canceled that one now. You prayed for the same thing. That's why they said, Jesus said, do not pray repetition. You know, you continue praying, thinking by the multitude of your word, you'll be heard. But that's what you do. Every Sunday you go to your church, you are praying for the peace of the world. Let there be peace in the world. Oh, I thought you say your God said, let there be light, and there was light. And he cannot say, let there be peace, and there is peace. He cannot. You keep praying. Every Sunday you are praying. You cancel the one you prayed last Sunday. You pray free. That's why your God cannot act, because he's waiting for you to live by faith. When you pray, believe you have received it. So don't continue praying. See? Prayer is supposed to be once. Once is enough. If your prayer works, if God exists, one prayer you pray on January 1 is enough to carry you throughout the whole year. You will not be wasting your time going for special camp, retreat, crusade, seminars, mountain, bullshit, bush dad, all that nonsense you are doing in the name of God. You cannot see God. That is exactly the same reason why you cannot see result of your prayers. Because you cannot see God. If you can see God, you can see the result of your prayer. You cannot see God. You say, I see God in my dream. That's the only place you can see the result of your prayers, in your dream. You have to get up and walk to see things you work for. You don't get anything you pray for. You get what you work for. Period. If you get what you pray for, you know you are a thief. But if you get what you work for, you are not a thief. You know, you relax and enjoy it. Praying to God is waste of time. You believe you are speaking things into existence, but you are just speaking words into the air. There's no God out there waiting for you to pray or watching over you to do anything for you. Is you are just speaking useless words, empty words in the air, and is stupidity. It is time you stop it. Grow up and begin to live humanly. Trust God, trust prayer, trust Jesus, trust spirituality, trust religion, and live your life well. Welcome to humanity. God bless.